My name is Bianca Alexis, and this is the first Westport Wildcat News episode of 2018. With the new administration this year, there has been a few changes regarding the senior privileges.
Recently at Westport Junior Senior High School, one of the senior privileges was taken away, and this didn't sit well with the students, but Dr. Demers has his reasonings.
I don't think they were changed, I just don't think they were never formalized, which I think is part of the problem. Students were just leaving classes early, there were no supervision, there's a liability issue if something that was to happen, but more importantly, what brought it to my attention was a parent came in looking for a student and we couldn't find that student, and I need to know where all the students are at all times.
Being a senior allows particular privileges.
You get to eat outside during lunch in the courtyard, you get to leave a couple minutes early for lunch, and you get to get out of school early, like in June or May, before everyone else.
Senior privileges are privileges that seniors get that everyone else does not.
Not all students agree on the senior privileges being taken away.
I don't think it's fair that we don't get to leave early for lunch. It's only 3 minutes. What's the big deal about that?
I feel like they're not completely taken away, and people are just complaining for the sake of going to lunch the same time they always do.
Well, I think it's bogus because, you know, we've had senior privilege here for as long as I can remember, and coming up as a freshman, sophomore, junior, I always just can't wait to be able to eat in the courtyard and go to lunch early. And then when they're taking our rights away from us without any representation, you know, that sounds like a rebellion.
I wasn't very happy about it. I think we should be recompensated with something else.
Many students expressed strong opinions on what they feel the new senior privileges should be.
Just give us back the 3 minutes and then everyone would be happy.
You know, we usually leave lunch 2 minutes early. We should make it five. And we should be able to just cut every kid in the line who's not a senior.
If seniors were interested in adding any additional senior privileges, then this is how they should go about it.
Well, senior privileges, the way they should work is seniors that want to do something a little bit different than the student body should make a proposal to the student council. Student council should put together a proposal to bring forward to administration, and then for approval.
With an opioid epidemic spreading across the country, the medication Narcan has become a very controversial topic, especially when schools consider carrying it.
It is the drug that can save a life, but in this little clear tube also lies a controversy, one that has only started a cultural debate across the country, but has many schools nationwide choosing sides.
Narcan is a medication that we use to reverse an opioid overdose. Currently, there are two types of Narcan. There's the nasal Narcan that we can use in the community. Lay people are able to have it. And then we have IV Narcan, which is what we use at the hospital through an IV if you were to experience an overdose from something like pills or heroin.
In Westport High, Narcan is not available. Administrators say if an overdose occurs, they have a plan in place.
The thought process is that all of our first responders actually have access to Narcan and it's readily available. So should we have access to Narcan in case of an emergency? Absolutely we should. Here in Westport, we feel that that accessibility is already a given, so we're leaving it up to the first responders at this point in time.
It may sound like a logical decision to most to have Narcan in schools, but defendants of the policy say having the medication readily available will have users seeing it as a safe risk to using opioids.
I feel that Narcan is more a reactive measure to a drug overdose. For schools, as an administrator, I like to think that we're more proactive, so we could take steps to kind of educate students, educate families the dangers of drugs. There's a no-tolerance policy for drugs in school. They don't belong in the building. So I'd like us to, you know, take more measures to make sure that students are safe while they're here, instead of, you know, having to react to a situation that shouldn't be taking place at all.
The opioid outbreak in the country has reached the highest levels in recorded history. Although the town of Westport has a low opioid population, Dr. Brittany Lynch of St. Anne's Emergency Department says our community and our school is not immune to the epidemic.
I support the use of Narcan. I have seen several people be revived from the use of Narcan. I think that having nasal Narcan out in the community has saved numerous lives. I think it's a way to reduce harm, and I do not think it increases the use of opioids.
With over 3.2 million teachers nationwide, it reveals the question, what is their motive?
Westport High School is very fortunate to have an outstanding staff who are passionate about what they do.
I teach because I absolutely love math, and even more, I absolutely love working with high school students and sharing with them my love of math.
It's a calling. I was born to teach, and I don't feel like I'm working. I enjoy the job so much. I enjoy working with students of high school age. And it's a passion of mine, so it's not like working.
I love it. I love to see the kids every day. I love to see the staff. I enjoy being here.
I continue to teach because it's an awesome experience seeing students graduate and pursue careers and come back and visit me and tell me about their successes and whatever else they've accomplished. And I just like seeing that growth and how I've hopefully made an impact on their lives.
One of the greatest rewards are seeing former students come back to thank them.
I've had students from the first group of students that I got to see from freshman year to senior year come back and let me know about their experiences and what they're doing. I can think of Matt Amaral. He was a student and athlete here. He shares, you know, his stories with me. He has a new niece. I get to hear about her. So it's good to see what they're up to after they leave the halls of Westport High.
I don't live far away from here, and those students who are in the area still, I'll bump into them in the mall, at church, where they work. They help me out. I used to help them out when they were kids in high school, and now they help me out in their jobs.
Oh, sure. I see students all the time. I was at Village Garage yesterday, and while I was there, one of my students came in, and we talked about, you know, how he was doing and so forth. So I see kids all the time. I know a lot of students who have started careers in science and math and engineering who probably started to like it when they had me as a student.
I think I touched different people in different ways over the years. Sometimes when they do come back, they'll tell me little stories about how something I did or said changed their lives. That is the most rewarding feeling ever. To really feel like you've influenced, you've helped, you've molded somebody's future.
Each year, the school offers their annual career fair, and this gives students opportunities to see what they might want to pursue after high school.
Having an opportunity to meet professionals from different careers gave students some insight on occupations they may not have thought about.
I think it's really helpful. You get to look at a bunch of different careers and go around and see different jobs and how people are doing them. You get to ask a lot of questions. I think it's awesome.
It could be helpful for like other students who like this field. They'll have people to talk to and other things to get them more into that job.
I'd say as long as they're open to trying to find something, then yeah, it's helpful.
I think it is helpful for people to find job opportunities and to see what they want to do in their life.
I definitely got to get more in-depth about business, and I got to be more in-depth about the military, and I think that talking to different people about different businesses is going to pique your interest in those different businesses.
For some, they would like to see more diverse fields represented.
I'd rather see like more of a broad range of jobs, so like mechanics and other things like that. That's what I'm looking for, you know?
I'd like to see an IT booth.
Next year, probably more engineers, just because I was looking into it and I definitely wanted to ask people about it, but there's not a table here for it, so.
I want to see more of in the hospital. I want to see more surgeons, more anesthesiologists, more people than just nurses.
Engineering type things and armed services.
Westport Junior Senior High School offers a gay straight alliance program that is open arms to everyone.
GSA is the Gay Straight Alliance, but it's not just about that. It's other things too. So we talk about like transgender issues. We talk about feminist issues, all those other things. And then if people come into the club with a problem or something they want to talk about, then we can also talk about that. I think it's a safe place for students to go to just voice anything that has happened to them. So it doesn't just have to be political issues. It can be just like, I tripped and fell today, and then we'll all just talk about it and talk it through. I don't think there are a lot of clubs that connect with like the students, like just one-on-one, because there are ones like DECA and things like that. They're mostly like school-related things, and then with this, it's like we're connecting with them as people, and so I think that's a good thing.
Bullying is an ongoing issue that occurs in children from kindergarten to 12th grade on a daily basis.
Recently, a video was uploaded online of 11-year-old Keaton Jones, who was repeatedly bullied at his school. We asked students if they were aware of the incident that has been projected online by celebrities and various other internet users.
I am aware of the bullying issues regarding Keaton Jones, and I find it pretty crazy that in one day he was labeled as, you know, an innocent victim of bullying, and overnight he was labeled as a child from a racist family whose mother used him to basically make money. And I think that's pretty crazy, and it just shows how crazy like media is and how it can reflect the truths of it.
I am aware of the incident regarding Keaton Jones. Obviously I feel bad for him, but I heard that his mother was all she wanted was money, and I feel like that's not really supportive. Like, I think she said just use my GoFundMe page or something like that. And even when an MMA fighter offered to take the son to a fight, she just said she just wanted money. So I feel like that's kind of selfish.
Bullying has been occurring for years, but it seems to have gotten worse in recent times, especially since the use of social media and online connections have enhanced. Students state their opinion on whether or not they believe celebrities could put an end to bullying.
I think the nationwide support of celebrities, like in a campaign or just a concentrated effort to stop bullying, I think they could definitely at least put an end to some bullying, because the more aware of it the American people are, the more educated they are, and they're more willing to stop bullying.
Yeah, I believe some, but not all.
Yes, I think because they have such strong and wide platforms, they can do a lot to speak out against it.
It is unknown of why anyone would bully another person. Students give some reasons on why they think people feel the need to tear down others.
There can be a few specific reasons, whether they have family troubles or inner emotional troubles. Oftentimes, most bullies aren't satisfied with themselves and who they are, so in order to distract themselves from that pain, they tear down others because it makes them feel good. So it just elevates them to a status that they don't deserve, because in reality, if they take that pedestal away, there's nothing there to stop them from falling into being a bully.
Maybe there's a problem at home, or maybe they're jealous of that person.
I think a lot of people have their own pent-up aggression that they need to cope with by hurting other people.
Fruit plays a major role in the lives of many, especially children and teens. Westport Junior Senior High School makes this known by encouraging healthy eating in their lunches.
Due to requirements at Westport High School, it is mandatory that students take a piece of fruit with their lunch. However, many students, after purchasing their lunch, will instantly throw the fruit away.
No, I actually believe that a lot of the fruit is wasted because most of the kids aren't thinking about it.
No, I think that they're just focused on like all the other good stuff, like the desserts and the chicken and the things that they really enjoy, and that's kind of like the last thing on their mind to eat.
It seems to be an ongoing issue. So I don't think that making it mandatory encourages any student to eat healthy whatsoever. Mr. Millett, as someone who buys fruit for the students every single day, speaks on this.
I see a lot of fruit thrown into the trash for no apparent reason. I think what happens is the kids get the lunch or a chicken patty or something that they brought from home, and the fruit's the last thing on their mind. They get full and they just throw it away.
He just gives out fruit, and I feel like because there's not other different food options, the kids will want to eat it from him.
I mean, not really at lunch, but when I'm in Millett's class, he always gets this huge bag of fruit, and there's like apples and bananas and oranges, and they'll eat from that.
And they have no other alternatives, so they eat the healthy fruit.
However, they came up with several ideas that will encourage good eating and a healthy lifestyle.
Maybe give them an alternative, like maybe serve it during the day, have the school store open during the day so people can buy something that's healthy for them.
You could always make a requirement to have a fruit on your plate as they require vegetables, but it doesn't seem like they're giving the students motivation to eat their fruit, so.
Many schools enforce strict rules regarding cell phones. Westport Junior Senior High School is a school that has a variety of opinions on this ongoing controversy.
According to an article by Family Education, studies show that 65% of cell-owning teens bring their phones to school despite any bans that may be in place. Students at Westport Senior Junior High School expressed how they feel about phones being used in schools.
They should be used more often. They're a really great piece of technology.
I think it should be like more acceptable. I think people get like really worked up about it for no reason.
It doesn't really matter because their phones, everybody has them, everybody uses them.
I think they're a great like learning tool, and they can help us connect as like a classroom with our teachers and everything. And like we have access to the internet, which can, I want to say, provide information, more information.
Many students acknowledge how phones can be beneficial.
You can do a lot of research on them and keep in touch with your teachers.
Like Kahoot or something for quizzes and classes that will help people learn.
My current issues class, we actually were told to use the cell phones because, like, to look up topics for what we want.
Many students believe that some people will abuse the privilege of using their phones in school.
Yeah, they probably, like, they go on other stuff and they probably shouldn't be doing that.
Most people will go on Instagram or Snapchat and, like, text their friends and all that, which shouldn't really be allowed.
Yeah, most of the kids do. They use other apps like Snapchat and Instagram when they're supposed to be looking up stuff.
I think a lot of people abuse the use of cell phones, and that's like probably one of the reasons why they're so demonized in our schools.
Some kids do when like you have classwork and they just take it out.
Yes, I think a lot of teachers in the school, especially Mr. Boynstein, demonize like cell phones, and he thinks they're all evil. They're a great like tool to connect. Like you can use them for history class to look up like certain topics.
Yeah, because they get a bad rep on them because most of the kids don't pay attention and they're on their phones when they're supposed to be doing the work.